We're back for more interview coverage at the Open Source Bridge Conference, and right now we're joined by Betsy Richter. Hi, Betsy.
Hi, Cami.
Where can we find you on Twitter and on the internet?
On Twitter, you can find me either at Betsy Wim or as one of the people manning the Our PDX account. And on the internet, you can find me in all kinds of ways.
Just about anywhere you want
Anywhere you want to, but...
Plus Mojito.
Plus Mojito, yeah. Do a search in Google, best Mojito recipe. I'm either number one or number two as of a couple days ago.
Yeah, so. And I will say that the only Mojito I've ever made and enjoyed was from Betsy's recipe.
Yeah, that's one of my many claims to fame.
But that's not what we're here to talk about.
No, we're not.
But in full disclosure, I should say that the blog that she will talk about in a moment, I am one of the writers on.
Yes.
So you should know that before we continue on our merry way.
Okay.
So
I have billed myself, and I'm starting to begin to embrace this notion of being one of the bossier people in Portland, mm-hmm. and I'm trying to just embrace the bossy.
Okay.
So that plays out in a number of ways. It plays out in work, where I get to manage a team of great people to try to get open source tools up for nonprofit standards organizations. Mm-hmm. It manifests itself as part of what I'm doing for our PDX. We've got 20 plus authors writing for us now.
Which is on an open source platform.
It's on an open source platform. It's on WordPress right now. Mm-hmm. And it was a labor of love, a cash flow negative operation, mm-hmm. I should say. No corporate sponsorship, although if you want to do a corporate sponsorship, come find me. But it's my side project that I love dearly. Mm-hmm. And then in my copious spare time, I boss around two kids. So
what is it that we want to talk about? Which part of the open source bossiness do we want to talk about today?
Today, the open source bossiness really, I'd love to talk about RPDX.
All right, let's go.
Which is my baby. We started RPDX just about a year ago. Mm-hmm. That will become important, as you'll see later on.
In a moment.
And it was really born from my frustration about not being able to blog about a story that had gotten dropped in my lap about mm-hmm. a local event. And so over the course of 8 days, our PDX was created. And I sent some email to some other folks who said, gosh, I'd love to write for you. I sent some email to other people who said, let me come in and help test your theme. So it was a real labor of love from the Portland community in general. And we launched, I want to say the unofficial launch was when we got outed.
Is that IP3?
No,
it was right before.
Right before IP3.
Yeah.
So I think our official launch date might be like the 21st or 22nd of June of last year. Mm-hmm. And one of the taglines that I've developed or said about RPDX before is, it was the blog by bourbon. because there were a few late nights there where it was me and the bottle and mm-hmm. trying to get things done. But it's up in 8 days and we got out. And now it's time to celebrate.
It is very, very nearly time to celebrate.
Nearly time to celebrate. So... we've been going great gangbusters. We've got about 24 people writing for us now. You can find us at rpdx.com,
rpdx.net,
rpdx.org, whatever the domain names that I could buy over time, I did.
Yeah.
But you'll find us also on Twitter at rpdx. And we've been having great fun with the Twitter account, too.
Mm-hmm.
So whereas on the blog itself, you'll read everything ranging from a really in-depth analysis of the renaming 39th Street in Portland to Ron Jeremy's new club opening in downtown Portland to the diary of a gentleman who works late nights in a porn store. On the RPDX Twitter account, we really specialize in things like doing, you know, live coverage of the PDX monkey breakout.
Man, that was some tense.
Those were tense
moments.
We were doing, you know, wall-to-wall storm team coverage of the monkey.
Yeah.
And he was sighted all over town.
Well, weren't there two monkeys?
There were two monkeys. There were four.
Four.
Then two. And then one lone little monkey hanging out there for about 48 hours.
That poor monkey must have been scared.
We had sightings of him at a plaid pantry mm-hmm. with a six-pack of PBR and some nachos.
Mm,
we had
nachos.
Sightings of him at Mary's Club, mm-hmm. you know, at the rail. We had sightings of the monkey all over the place. So we just got to disseminate and share that information on the Twitter account.
And so now we're gently rubbing up against a year of RPDX.
Yes, we are.
And what are we going to do about it?
We are going to celebrate. The first thing we're definitely going to do is that Justin Kistner in Beer and Blog has graciously allowed us to take center stage at Beer and Blog next Friday night at Green Dragon, because where else do you go for Beer and Blog? Most of the time is Green Dragon. And we will have an anniversary cake there. We'll be talking about some other fun and interesting things we do as part of that. Because we are a cash flow negative operation, I'd love to buy you all beer. We really can't afford to do that.
Okay, you're going to have to buy your own beer.
Yeah, you're going to have to buy your
own
beer.
Or get someone else to
buy
it for
you. Or you can buy me a beer. You can buy, you know, any of one of the authors.
I think that's a good idea.
I think there should be a strategy that says,
I think the authors, in order, because when you go to a birthday party, don't you bring a present?
Right.
So instead of bringing presents for the blog or for the authors, you should buy the authors a drink.
Absolutely.
I'd say a drink, not beer, because I don't drink beer and I'm an author. And
right.
I'd like to get on the list.
And if you wanted to buy a beverage for Miss Cami Chaos here, what would you buy?
At Green Dragon, you would buy Dirty Dry Gin Bridges, or 12 Bridges. Is that 12 Bridges?
12 Bridges.
Yeah, martini.
Mm-hmm.
So they're good.
Yeah, we may end up having drink orders up on the blog at some point, or maybe over Twitter.
That's a really good idea.
Yeah, we'll just give you a nice little shopping.
I think that's a great idea. We should get all the authors who are going to be present to tell us what their drink orders are, and then we'll just post it up on there. Or, you know, we could give a cheat sheet to the bar.
Mm-hmm.
And then they can just say who they want to buy a drink for.
And I see opportunity here.
I see opportunity.
Not at all, you know.
Dangerous opportunity.
Dangerous opportunity here. I'm just glad that I have a designated driver now already.
Teenage son?
No.
Oh, okay.
My teenage son will never, ever, ever have the keys to my car, ever.
That's very cute.
If you're watching, kiddo, never, never, never.
Not gonna happen.
No.
Not gonna happen. I had to figure out which camera we were at.
Yeah.
They're conveniently labeled.
I know,
but
they are.
Yeah.
And then, if that weren't enough to be doing the wonderful celebration at Green Dragon.
This is the reason you can't buy us too many drinks.
Yes. Because we, I'm told, will be the special guest star on Strange Love Live.
Next week. Strange Love Live is going to the authors.
Yep.
We probably won't hear a lot from Betsy. We probably won't hear a lot from Diesel Boy. But the authors of RPDX are going to be joining us on the couch and in the studio audience of Strange Love Live to talk about what they're doing on the blog, to talk about what they like to do, and what special pieces they each bring to it.
Yes. And I'm told that we will hopefully can get Wizard Boots out there. I'm hoping.
I'm thinking, I think he works. We've had him in the studio audience before. I think the shift is we just have to get him on first.
Right.
And then we have to let him go.
We'll arrange that.
Yeah.
But we've got a couple of some of our more reticent authors that you wouldn't normally have seen at an RPDX gathering, for example, who have made the commitment that not only will they be at the anniversary party, they will also be at Strange Love Live.
And there's going to be a little, I don't know, for those of you who are familiar with my love of tiki, and with tiki internet-related things in general, there will be a little tiki surprise on Strange Love Live that evening.
Yes, and because we're all about giving back and we're all about creating like an open source community in general, the message that went out to the RPDX authors last night was, so that Cami and Mike are not bearing the cost alone, everybody's required to bring a bottle or two of their favorite rum.
Because it will be a tiki open source birthday for RPDX.
Yeah, absolutely.
All right.
And we're so looking forward to it.
So let me get, you know, derail from that and get back to the conference. What are you doing here at the conference?
I really was a last-minute attendee because I wasn't sure if I'd be able to clear the schedule from the day job.
Mm-hmm.
But a lot of what I'm trying to do is, if you might not have guessed before, I know a lot about technology, but I put my knowledge very much in the, I know just enough to know when people are blowing smoke at me. Part of my goal here is to deepen my own technology knowledge so that I can really nail you in 10 seconds as opposed to 30 seconds.
Which is where we get back to the whole bossy syndrome.
The bossy thing, right? But with that, it also has been really valuable for me to learn more about some of the technologies that we're utilizing as part of WordPress, for example, and we're having the WordPress user group meeting tonight as a Birds of Feather session here.
In the exhibition hall at what time?
It's going to be 7 o'clock. It's going to be in the steel room, and we'll have steel room. We're going to have the usual gathering, and hopefully some people from OS Bridge will stay along and be part of that group.
You do not have to be a registered OS Bridge attendant to attend the Birds of a Feather session.
No, and you'll find more information on the Portland WordPress user group blog, which you'll find at pdxwp.com.
Excellent. All right. Is there anything else you're looking forward to? Are you going to be here tomorrow for the unconference?
I will. I have to take a look at the sessions first and see which ones I want to carve time out for.
Mm-hmm.
I will say that one of the more valuable sessions that I got a chance to witness yesterday was the, you know, our assholes killing your project session. We have a lot of deep learning that I'm taking back to the office.
We've got the footage. I think we might actually play some of that B-roll tomorrow if we have a chance to. So. All right. Well, Betsy, thank you so much for joining us again.
You're welcome.
See you next week. Actually, absolutely. I'll see you before then.
You'll see me before then. You know that.
They'll see you next week.
Yeah.